Welcome back to my RV. I am happy that you're here with me. Welcome back. Today I'm trying to sort out the electrical system. I haven't gotten very far with the batteries, but I did figure out you could plug it in, but you need a 30 amp system. I don't know what that means. I'm not an electrician, but I learned it from some other dubious sources on YouTube. So what I decided, I spent a lot of time at my folks. Occasionally I'll swing by, see how they're doing. They're all old and decrepit, and things, their bones are all brittle. They'll probably be dead in a couple weeks. So I thought I might stick around, occasionally pop by, and I was gonna plug in, set up a system where I could just plug in when I stop by to visit and just mooch off them. It's everyone's dream to live in an RV outside of their parents' house. So that's how I'm gonna set up. Again, a lot of people on YouTube, they'll tell you not to do electrical work if you don't know what you're doing. I have no idea what I'm doing, but I'm not a pussy. I grew up in a house where we did our own surgery and our own dentistry, and we birthed children. It didn't matter. But I did a little research, figure out what I needed. So if you ever want to do this, that's why I'm doing this little video, show you if you want to do something and set up a similar system for your RV, your house, that's not that hard. Well, I mean, I don't know if it's that hard, but I watched some videos on electrical work and it seemed not tough. 30 amp service, 30 amp breaker. Then you want the female plug, and you want your plug to be in a box. It'll go in this little box here, and all this can be purchased. I spent $60 for the whole system. You think how much people pay for their electrical bill? I'm not gonna pay my parents' electric bill. I'm just gonna be sucking, just taking it right off there. So you have this, you'll need a box. I want a waterproof box for outdoorsy. You need the wire. You want to do a little research. You can ask the man at the electrical store, say I got a 30 amp service for an RV, and they'll normally tell you the right wire to get. This is this wire here is gray, so I went with a gray wire. You'll need that. That's all the equipment you'll need, and you'll also need, if you don't know how to do electrical work, you'll also need a big set of balls. So go ahead and put your balls on the table. So you'll need those, and you'll need all of this stuff. The balls, and this. So let's go outside and see what we're doing. All right, if you come out here, if you look right next to my generator, we have this guy here. I don't know the official term, but I'm going to call it a plug, right? And this is what I'm going to want to plug into my newly installed outlet, well, soon to be installed outlet. And you come over here, this is all the beautiful scenery which I'll be overlooking while I'm leeching off my parents, taking their electricity. And right here, this used to be a little basement window situation, and I'm gonna use that to get to the basement. All right, here is the unused 30 amp, which will be mine. And it's down here in this. And down here in this Buffalo Bill style torture chamber, which is nice because no one will hear you scream down here if I was to want to do things to hitchhikers. I'm going to run it right from, that is said piece of plywood, you can't see it very well back there, up see doozy and right up into the panel. I decided with my brain that it might be easier to put together the plug assembly before I am outside and have to do that, so I'll do that in here first. I have this nice box here for which the plug will go in, and with it comes this little watertight attachment deal. So I'll shove that guy right up in the bottom. Whoop, nice and tight. then I'll take some of the aforementioned wire and I'll jam her right up in there. Give myself a little bit of slack. I was inserting it first before I stripped the wire, so that way it would be easier to get in. Okay, positive and negative seems to be an important thing with electricity. Who knew? So you want to make sure the negatives with the positive. And the way I remember it, the black wire is positive and will usually, on a screw or on an outlet, they'll be gold and they'll be silver. A way to remember that is black people like gold. I'm positive of it. And white people can be very negative, so the white wire will go to the silver. So there that is. And then the green is ground. And you can remember that by green being ground. Then you want to pop out this business. And then you get this little guy here. Come on, you fucker. I'm going to score it. Sure, there's a better way to do this, but as it's my first time, I'm not disheartened by how long it takes.
Oh shit!
Did that scare you? Scary down here. Alright, so I just gotta get that wire over to the panel. Where did it go? Everywhere. I want it to be as tidy as possible. I'll come back later and put on some clamps. Howdy folks. If I'm gonna get killed during this little project, it'll be right here. At the old panel, so Jah, Rastafari, watch over eye. And don't think I wouldn't know the irony of dying with a flash shirt on, but I'm gonna try my best not to die. I think this is the main, the big one at the top. Shut everything off, so I think that's good. So I'm gonna take this cover off. Hold that for me, Santa. Whoa. What a mess. Feeding my wire up through the bottom. Figure out about as much as I need. Give myself a tiny bit more. Some of you may notice that my wire is now orange and not gray. And if you did, good on you for paying attention. I was about 2 foot short with my exterior wire. So I went and asked the man, can I get some more gray? And he's like, you don't need gray, bro. You can get orange. You're indoors now. I'm like, oh, snap. So I got orange. Also rated for 30 amp. And a little bit cheaper. Looks like the ground has to go into what I believe is called a bus bar. Not the ground. Ugh. That would have been bad. Looks like the white one here. You know why? Because that's silver. If you're going to be dumb and do stupid things like this, you need to be observant. Both the negative and the ground. What the fuck? It's very confusing. I don't know. I'm just going to shove the ground in there. That made me really nervous. This side is black, so I'm going to replace that with a black one. I'm going to shove the white one in where the red one was. I don't know if that's going to be the right thing to do, but this camera's here for evidence, so I just want my family to know that I love them very much. And thank you guys for watching. I hope somebody finishes the video. It's on my laptop under being a jackass. Alright, well, I'm not dead. Still don't have power of the RV. We had power for like a second and then the breaker popped. I take back what I said about being a pussy by not doing electrical work if you don't know what you're doing. I mean, I still think it's worth a shot to try things, and I'm still going to keep trying. If I actually figure out what's going on, I switched that panel about 8 different ways. So, maybe it's in the RV. I should probably get an electrical tester and test the outlet, but I just thought I'd use my RV as an electrical tester. Anyway, so tonight it's another windows open night. And, yeah, hopefully I can figure it out. If I figure it out, this is the worst tutorial for RV maintenance ever. Maybe. I don't know. There's some pretty shit ones out there, but this is right up there at the top. If you watch all the way to the end, I apologize. Usually at the end, there's the big dramatic reveal, but I got nothing. I got nothing for you. If things change, I'll let you know, but I don't see that happening. I'll probably just... The answer to this tutorial will be, just call a motherfucker who does electrical work, you cheap ass. Well, how much you gonna charge me just to hook up all the wires to the right places, I think. I don't know. Whatever. Anyway, I'll see you guys later. And you guys take it easy. Bye-bye.